This could be a significant video for you and for Ping, the i230s. They're replacing the i210s, which we see on our TV. We're looking at the likes of Lee Westwood, Victor Hovland, Tyrrell Hatton. They're all using the i210s. Are we going to see them in the i230s? The great news, I think, about this iron is we see them in loads of other people's bags at our golf course as well. It's a stalwart of the Ping iron family. It sits right in the middle. Okay, it can go either way. I'm always quite shocked when I see the professionals using these. You see, Lee Westwood even writes his yardages with marker pen on the back of his club head. I think that's really awesome. We can use these irons as well as the likes of Victor Hovland. So my name is Sophie Walker. This is the Golfalot channel. Today we're at Denton Golf Club and it's all about the Ping i230s. Now, the word on the driving range amongst the tour pros that I've asked who have changed to these, the likes of Maya Stark, she said, "I'm getting more spin." Right away, I think I know why, the Micromax grooves. So today I'm going to be testing these against my i525s, not in terms of which ones goes further, because that should be obvious. It's to find out who these irons are more suited for. I'm going to use it on the driving range with some 6-irons, so comparing the looks and the performance to the i525s. Then I'm going to take them out on a golf course and play some holes, put these into action. Now, Ping have sent me a fair amount of these irons, so I get to look at the 4-iron. Is it scary? Is it playable? They look great. They look really polished. They look a lot less, well, i210s, there's too much cut out for them. These look smoother. All about this back cap as such here. There's more in this than it looks. They're hiding some technology in there. I want to get some numbers, get some first impressions, and then talk to you through the technology. I've grabbed a few numbers with the 6-iron i525. I'm going to move into the i230 now. I know there's going to be some difference. There should be, okay? But I want to get the data and then some feels from them. That is a noticeably higher ball flight. Hitting these straighter actually, but the launch is higher than the i525s. Different shaft, obviously. This is a steel, that's a graphite, but it's a similar weight. I've hit 5 in a row there, like poker straight. Spin rate is up. It's up 300 to 500 RPM. The flight's up. The feel's better. The i525s are tingy. I know that, but I need the performance in them. These feel sweeter, softer than those i525s. Less hollow, in fact. Well, it looks different to me. It feels different. We need to look at the data, but there's a definite difference between these and the i525s, which there should be. So let's get into it. First things first, looks. Now, interestingly, the i525 has a thinner top edge, in my opinion, than the i230s, but that's possibly because the i525 is elongated. They make the blade longer, so it appears thinner as well. Sole-wise, the 6-iron on the i230 is slimmer than the i525s. It's a more compact head. It is a smaller head, but it's not scary. I actually like it a little bit more than the i210. I think the shaping is better in the i230. Sound-wise, night and day between these two clubs. The i230 has got a great sound to it. It's got a quieter sound, a less clicky sound, more better players' clubs. But I wouldn't say that it's really hard to hit. I mean, it's a bit cold in Manchester, but I'm off a mat. It's not horrendously hard to hit. I always are taken aback when you see the players that I've been mentioning in this video use the i210s. Because it's almost like, why are you not using the i59s or the blades like Finau does? I mean, the blades are really, really thin, but I just assumed more players would use the i59s. We're just not seeing that. Maybe because they're getting the feel that they want, but they're getting the forgiveness as well. So why make it harder for yourself? Looking through the data, noticeable differences. I saw it with the ball flight. We're looking at maybe a club less in distance because the i230s launch higher, they fly higher, they spin more. I was getting actually a lot more neutral shape with them. It's easier to hit them straighter. The i525s, I kind of wanted to turn over a bit. But if we're looking at the average in carry, 136 compared to 143. I did get a 143 with the i230s. I've already spoke about the spin rate. It was like 6,000 nearly on the i230s and 500 less with the i525s. Launch wise, up again. It's basically a club difference. I would say the i230s are more of that true six iron than the hollow i525s. We're getting more into that player's style of iron. It's good though, it's nice. It's really not that hard to hit. I can see why Lee Westwood goes, well, why don't I have these instead of the blades? Absolutely. Huge difference in sound. You heard it. Tell me you heard it on this video. I mean, night and day. The range testing has proven the difference between these two irons. Now I'm gonna forget about the i525, done. We're going i230 out on the golf course, having a go with the irons, different situation, lies, different clubs. Let's get a playing feel for these i230s. First up, a little par three. I'm thinking knockdown shot into the wind. Let's get a yardage. 130, or just short of 130, but into the wind. So I think it's gonna play around just short of 140. So being on the driving range, I know that a regular six iron probably isn't gonna get there. So I'm just gonna try and launch one lower and try and get one to penetrate through the wind. I would expect these irons to be more shot shaping. As I say, they sit between i525s and i59s. Bit high launch. Was it me? Was it the club? I'm gonna hit another one. I wanna hit another one. I felt like I've lent on that. Take two. I mean, that's pin high. It just wasn't fizzed. Come on, Soph. Try and get some shaft lean. Yeah, a little bit lower, but really had to turn the face over. I am launching these. Pew. Too high. Let's talk technology. We've got the Micromax screws, which is gonna make spin a lot more consistent. They're a lot better in all weathers as well, especially if there's some rain between ball and club face. We're trying to keep the spin more consistent. We've got high MOI. We've got 431 stainless steel body, tungsten weighting towards the toe and that little bit towards the heel to add the stability. Next, you've got the elastomer insert. That's all to do with the feel. That's hidden by this cavity badge here. Something that we didn't see on the i210s. We are now hiding what's going on behind the head, making everything look that little bit cleaner. The long irons, there's a difference between the i210s. It's more of a compact head. So from six iron down, the head size is the same as the i210s. But with the i230s, we've got more of a compact shape. You really can see that. I don't mind that. I spoke to Laura Davis about this and she said about using a two iron rather than a hybrid. It concentrates her mind a little bit more. I'm on that wavelength as well. I'm obviously not as good as her, but I quite like something shorter and more compact in my hand for a longer iron, which I know some of you might not quite get. I like that. We've seen that with the drivers. When I get a small driver, focus my mind, the strike on it. So four iron to lay up. Looks nice behind the ball. Nothing wrong with that. It's funny, isn't it? When it's into the wind, I'm like, oh, I can't keep it down. When you've got four iron in your hand, you just want to fly it as high as you can, don't you? And get it to go as far as you can. So in the long irons, I'm all for the launch. can't ever make myself happy, can I? It is a really nice looking head. It's got the smoothness to it. And all those grooves, actually, I think that's a good thing, looking down on it. Right, okay, 8 iron. Ooh, bit downwind, that one really chased. Okay, so maybe that extra flight downwind obviously is gonna get me more distance. There's three loft options in these. We've got the standard, the retro, and like the power lofts. With a lot of companies, I like that S in the tight list, the strong loft. So that might be something that I'm considering, but it's good that Ping offer three standard options for lofts to suit your game. They're into custom fitting, aren't they, at Ping? We know that. Final hole of the testing. I've got an 8 iron. Let's try and stick it close. I think I'm getting caught in two minds here. The club itself looks like it's gonna go, okay? It doesn't look like it's gonna perform in the same height and feel as a real kind of player's club. And I think that's what Ping do well. And also what makes it different to other companies. Is this or that with Ping? With other companies, you've got an array of irons. These i230s look like they're gonna go miles. Don't, they perform like an MB, maybe an MC. They just don't look like that. A really good day of testing with the i230s. I was saying this while I was out on the golf course. Ping offer you less than other companies. As in, it's not, well, I've made a little change, try this. We're gonna go da, 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 da. Not really. You know, they've got the blades, then they've got the i59s, then they've got the i230s, i525s, then they go into the Gs. I actually think the ones that sit either side of the i230, you're gonna see less and less players use. I think I'm a very different golfer than most people watching this video and the tour players. That's why I'm an i525. Don't see many tour players using the blade. We're gonna see lots of people at your golf club who are in the g425s, loads. But then I think you're gonna see the i230s come in to the better players. I'm thinking single figures and below. But how many times do I say, oh, this iron suits single figures, but not necessarily tour pros? Say it all the time. TaylorMade, Cobra, Callaway, all the time. I'm not saying it with this Ping though. I'm saying, you lot at home, you can definitely use this. But you are also gonna see the best players in the world play them. Price-wise, we're looking at £180 for steel, £190 for graphite. That's up there with the Callaway Apex. These are good-looking clubs with really nice metals. But they're not going to come out next year and say, we've tweaked it, we've made it slightly better. Bubba, change to this. Lee, change to this. You're not going to see that. We might not even see them move into the i230s because Ping make irons to last. We've seen them with the older models. I mean, Westwood used those Ping Zings forever and a day, didn't he? They back themselves when making a longevity iron. This is exactly the same. The i230s, I do think we'll see players move into them. I've already seen Maya Stark have them in the bag and they're not out yet. She tops the race to Costa del Sol on the Ladies European Tour at the moment. She'll be playing Solheim. That's okay. Ping aren't gonna force you to change. And I like that as a purchaser because I'm not gonna walk onto the golf course next year and think, oh, these are out of date. No, these are here to stay. The i230s, a very good club, which are going to appeal to so many golfers at the golf club and on tour. And I don't say that very often about irons. Ping i230s, that's a wrap. Thank you, Denton, for having us. If you want to read the written review, check it out on golfalot.com. Thank you all for watching once again, and I'll see you all again next time.